UTF-8 supporting SQL Server 2019 is another interesting addition to the rich set of features in SQL Server. Let's talk more about it. UTF-8 is offered in SQL Server 2019 via available collations ending in underscore UTF-8. These collations allow you to store, import, and export data in Unicode without using NCAR and NVARCHAR data types. So by using CAR and VARCHAR, you can still use Unicode in SQL Server. This allows for significant storage savings, because in case you use NCAR or NVARCHAR, you need twice the size for storing data when compared to CAR and VARCHAR. Now let's see a demo and see in action the UTF-8 support in SQL Server 2019 later. So now in this demo, in SQL Server 2019, I'm going to create another database when compared to the previous demo, and this time I will name it Test Unicode 2. However, this time I'm going to use a collation that supports Unicode. Therefore, I'm going to use Latin 1 General 100 Case Insensitive Accent Sensitive SC underscore UTF-8. So the collation I chose to use supports Unicode UTF-8. So I have created the database. Let's use it. And similarly to the previous lecture's demo, I'm going to create two tables. The first table is a standard table with a name column and its data type is set to VARCHAR. The second table has a column set to the NVARCHAR data type. Let's create these two tables, and like I did in the previous demo, I'm going to insert some Greek characters in both tables. The first table without NVARCHAR, instead it uses VARCHAR, and the second one which uses NVARCHAR. So let's do that, and now let's run select statements against both tables in order to see if my data is properly stored and represented in the two tables. So yes, you can see that this time the results of both tables are correct. So what I did here, I chose to use a collation that supports UTF-8 encoding for Unicode data. And in the standard, in the T-standard table, I used a name column of the data type VARCHAR. And still you can see that by the time I'm using this collation, my Greek characters are properly stored and represented in the table. So in this case, now I do not need to use NVARCHAR because my data is already stored in Unicode format without requiring twice the size of the table for storing Unicode data. This is a great addition in SQL Server 2019, and it offers more scalability, significant storage savings, and more performance for Unicode-based data. This video is part of my online course, Essential SQL Server Administration Tips. Check the video description for enrolling to the course with a major discount. Thank you for watching this video.